Hi, second grade. Today we're going to be working with past tense verbs. So this way we can remember that most of those verbs that show past tense, we're going to get that by finding our clue. It has an ED at the end of the verb. It means it happened in the past. Remember that? It already happened. Now, I do want you to remember that we do have some verbs that are irregular. That's what we call them, is irregular verbs. And they don't follow a rule of just adding ED to the end of it, because it doesn't make sense. For example, go. Go is in present tense. It's happening right now. And we didn't goad anywhere, right? You can't add that ED to go to make it past tense. We have to say went. That is past tense for go. What about see? If our verb is see, are you going to add an ED on the end of that? Look what happens. Well, that's just silly right there. So no, we can't do that. What did we do if it's past tense? We saw. We saw something, okay? So, or, this is an even better one. Look at this. We have seen. We have seen it. So, we see it. We saw it, or we have seen it. Both of these are in the past. Okay? Those are those irregular ones. Those are the ones that we just have to remember. All right, let's get rid of those. Bye-bye, irregular verbs. Now, we're going to focus on the ED. So take a look at the second bullet point right over here. There he is. Some verbs end with an E. We know this. Some words, they just end in E. But does that mean that we add another ED? So it ends up looking like this? No way. So we have to get rid of one of those E's and then just add the ED. Okay? So, next one. They allowed us to cook alone. What is the subject in they allowed us to cook at home? Find our subject. Our subject is they. What did they do? What's our verb? It is underlined on there if you're taking a look. Allowed. Allowed us to cook alone. So, does this allow, that's our base word, does allow end with an E? No. So we're going to just add our ED. Take a look at the next one. He needed eggs for the recipe. What's our subject? He. What did he do? He needed. I know it's underlined, but it's always good to say it. He needed eggs for the recipe. So, our verb is needed. What's our base word without the suffix on there? Need. Does it end in E? Nope. So we just add ED. The third example. Evan's parents liked our cooking. What's our subject? What's the subject? Not just a noun, but the subject. Evan's parents. Right? So you can see right here, Evan's, we have an apostrophe S. That's possessive. Whose parents? Evan's parents. What did they do? What's our verb? Liked. Let's find our base. like. Does the word like end in with an E? Did it? It does. So, instead of just adding ED, look what that would look like. Like-ed? Oh no, that just looks silly, doesn't it? So we have to take one of those out. We're going to drop that one and add the ED, so that way it looks just like that. Liked. We don't want to have too many of those E's in there. There we go. So the rest of this worksheet, what I'd like for you to do is it's going to give you the verb in the parentheses. Okay? So take that verb, make it past tense, and then rewrite that sentence out. You can go back to the PowerPoint and check your answers. Bye.